It started with his own words. Words that made the world take notice. Really take notice.
Why can't you share your vid?
Was it an innocent, loving friendship or something much darker? As the trial of the century gears up, Martin Bashir returns to the secret world of Michael Jackson, exploring his pattern of unusual friendships with much younger boys that began more than 20 years ago.
I've had to ask myself, could his allegations of what happened after that day be true? Once again, this would be a journey into the surprising, the unusual, and the bizarre. Were these relationships innocent, as Jackson and many of the boys say, or were some of them criminal, as at least two boys have alleged?
She touched the button of my shirt to open it, and I took my hands like this.
In Tatum O'Neill's recent book, she denies trying to seduce Jackson. Whatever his experience with girls, he would soon begin a series of friendships with boys much younger than himself.
And then he had younger kids that were friends, because you have to remember, Michael was so loved by everybody, which he still is, in the world, that everybody wants to be around him.
He feels very strongly that he missed out on his childhood. And one of the ways that he feels that he can recapture his youth is by associating with, you know, young kids.
Terry George claims he was one of those boys. For the rest of the Jacksons, it was just another stop on their 1979 European tour. But for Michael, says Terry George, it was a chance to make a new friend.
What is your name? Michael Jackson.
You know, him giving me his number and asking for mine didn't really feel strange at all. It was great. It was a thrill. It was, you know, I was happy to be in touch with a celebrity.
He spoke about masturbation. About him masturbating. Did I masturbate?
A source close to the Jackson camp said Terry George's story isn't true.
He went through this phase in his life where he became extremely shy and totally changed.
And music's brightest new star was about to go on a date with Brooke Shields. But in his private life, Michael's new best friend was the tiny child star, Emmanuel Lewis.
Regardless of how old we were in real life, we're not going to get older. That was just a friend of mine. We were Peter Pan.
And met Michael while he was having his makeup done.
And he's like, are you afraid of me? You know? Of course not, you're Michael Jackson.
But according to a Jackson biographer, some members of Jackson's family were becoming concerned about how the world would view this friendship.
They would do all the Thriller moves together and all, it's so cute, so adorable. Do all those little things together, and no, there were no questions about it because it was a wonderful friendship. I recall Brooke being over to the house and asking Michael if she could go with him.
He liked her, but he liked Emmanuel better.
He didn't want to say no, so he had two dates.
The extraordinary spectacle was seen around the world.
You can imagine the surprise and shock that everybody felt that Michael Jackson and Brooke Shields were a couple with Emmanuel Lewis.
People wanted to know why Michael Jackson was hanging around with a boy less than half his age, but according to Emmanuel, this was just an innocent friendship.
I mean, all we did was watch, you know, comedy or cartoons. Could anything negative happen between the two of us? The answer to that question, was hell no.
His relationship with boys looked like just one more eccentricity from a man who was becoming famous for being odd. One of the first boys to benefit from Michael's newfound wealth was the son of a Californian garbage man, 10-year-old Jimmy Safechuck. The young actor was picked by Jackson to star in this glossy commercial, designed specifically to appeal to kids, in which Michael's image became indelibly linked to children. Looking like Michael became part of the pattern for some of Jackson's young friends.
It starts to make you wonder, who's making them dress that way? Do they want to dress that way, or does Michael insist that they dress that way? I saw the Safechucks lifestyle change, and it wasn't just this child appearing in one video with Michael Jackson that gave them all that money.
When you put enough out there, it looks a certain way. However, at the same time, when you're innocent, you don't think anything of it.
I've known Michael Jackson, and I just know how he is with people and how he is with families of the people that, you know, come into his life. I mean, he's been generous to a fault.
One of Michael Jackson's young friends claims that Jackson stayed at his home. This man, we'll call him Jeffrey, had been 9 when he sent Jackson a poem. That night, he says they watched TV and played video games. Like Jimmy Safechuck and Emmanuel Lewis, Jeffrey says that nothing sexual happened between him and Michael Jackson. Corey Feldman was one of Michael Jackson's best-known young friends. Feldman finally got his chance to meet Jackson on the set of the 80s smash hit movie, The Goonies. Feldman says they spoke for 2 hours, and a friendship between a man and a boy began. He became obsessed with the star, dancing like him, even dressing like him. Feldman also says he noticed a book on Jackson's coffee table. The book contained pictures of naked men and women. He said Jackson sat down, showing him the pictures. Feldman has stood up for Jackson on many occasions since that time, most recently in 2003. He decided to buy a place of his own to finally create his private world.
I wanted to put the whole Disney thing in our house, and my mother wouldn't let him, so he says, I'm going to buy this property, I'm going to do what I wanted to.
When Michael saw the movie Home Alone at Christmas, he asked his housekeeper to contact its young star, Macaulay Culkin.
You and Mac have had quite an extensive relationship. Is this true?
Yes, I mean, we've known each other for about 4 years now.
4 years?
4 or 5 years.
How did you guys meet?
We met, Lincoln Center.
Lincoln Center?
In the Nutcracker.
You were in the Nutcracker?
Mac's a great dancer.
He is?
But according to Macaulay and Michael Jackson, nothing improper or sexual ever took place.
People, that's really what they kind of don't get, is that it's, you know, he has this bedroom, but at the same time, it's two stories. But, yeah, and it wasn't anything, like, weird. It wasn't anything we thought about. We go to the movies, and we do this, we do that. And it's like, okay, you know, just you plop down, you go to sleep, you wake up. You know, it's like, it was just kind of what friends do. I've slept in the same bed as, like, you know, a bunch of my friends. It's kind of just what happens, you know.
And for the moment, many parents were happy to let them.
Because it's Michael Jackson and he's a celebrity, people's judgment seems to fly out the window, particularly these parents.
But he was about to meet the boy who'd change his fate forever.
What was significant was the ride to Neverland. Michael's in the front with the chauffeur. Sitting on Michael's lap is a young boy about 12 years old. Michael was caressing this boy in a clearly sensual way, kissing him on the cheeks, on the neck, caressing him. It was overtly sexual.
If the boy is telling the truth, they detail a slow and steady seduction.
But he's not a child molester.